This is part two of the series, Setting Up the Grade Center in Blackboard, where we're going to cover setting up the Grade Center to use with a total points grading scheme. If you haven't already, please watch the previous video to understand how we got to this point. After establishing your course grading structure, it's time to build it in Blackboard. I always recommend setting up the Grade Center at the beginning of the semester, which will help keep things organized and ready to go once grading starts. To begin, I usually start by adding any items within my Blackboard site that will generate an automatic column in the Grade Center. These items include Blackboard assignments, tests, surveys, and graded collaborative items such as discussion boards, blogs, journals, and wikis. You can learn more about creating these separate items by watching our tutorials, whose links are available in the description box below. Once all items have been created, it's time to add columns that were not automatically generated. To do that, enter into the full Grade Center. You can see that I have several assignments and tests that were created using Blackboard's tools and subsequently had columns automatically created. I can now create the additional columns that I'll need for this semester. For example, let's say that I have a paper pretest that I give to students on the first day of class. This is something that I'll manually grade and enter into the Grade Center, so I'll need to create a column by clicking on the Create Column button. I enter in a name for the column, then move down to enter in a point value. You can enter in other optional information, but a name and point value are all that are required when creating columns. If you just want a record of student attempts and to not count it toward their grades, you can even enter in a zero value here. You may also choose to change the display values for the column to letter grades or percentages. Just remember that the Grade Center is still based in points, so changing the display method will only show how a grade is displayed to you. It will not change how the final grade is calculated. Optionally, you can also choose to set the category for this column. Once everything looks good, click Submit to save your changes. You can now see that the column has been added to the end of the Grade Center. I'll now repeat this process to add all the columns I need for my graded items. Once you have all the columns created, you've successfully set up the Grade Center using a total points grading scheme. As the semester progresses and grading begins, the final grade will calculate and be displayed in the total column. As always, if you have any questions or concerns, please contact the service desk at 368-HELP or at help.case.edu. You may find it helpful to learn more about the Grade Center by watching the other videos in the Grade Center playlist.